Welcome, my dear students of class 9A and 9B to my history class. Here there are certain points mentioned in the board. Please look at it. First point, grammar. Second point, epics. Third point, archaeological sources. Archaeological sources are of three parts. Number one, excavation or megaliths. And number two, coins. Number four, inscription. And number five, hero stones. These are the 1, 2, 3, 4 parts of archaeological sources. Now I am going to explain. The first one, grammar. You know, Talkappiyam is one of the earliest grammar book in Tamil history, in the history of the Sangam age. And this grammar was written in Tamil language. The authorship of this book has still not been traced. The name of Talkappiyam comes from the combination of two Tamil words, number one, Tonmai. What is the meaning of Tonmai? The meaning of Tonmai is ancientness. And number two, Kapiyam. Kapiyam means literature. That means ancient literature. From these two Tamil words, Talkappiyam has come. So this is about grammar. And second one, epics. Second point, epics. During the later Sangam age, Emirapakkiyam, means five great epics of Tamil literature, were composed. They were Silkappiyam, Manikkarala, Sivaka, Sintamai, Valiyappahi and Kudanakeswari. These were the most important, part of epics during the Sangam age. The Empakkiyam were written over a period spanning the 1st century CE to the 10th century CE and provide valuable information about the social, political, religious and cultural life under the Sangam kings. And not only that, Salivakaram is the most prominent of this. It deals with Kohalan's love for a courtesan and Madhavi, courtesan called Madhavi. And Monikame is a story of the daughter of Kohalan and Madhavi. So these epics were written on the basis of their love between Kohalan and Madhavi, the romantic scenes, the romantic situations, love, pessimistic views, each and every part of this, of their, you know, activities are written in this famous, you know, epics. And next one, archaeological sources. Archaeological sources are of four categories. Number one, excavations or megaliths. Number two, coins. And number three, inscription. Number four, hero stones. Now, what is excavations? Excavation at various sites around Tamil Nadu and Kerala have brought to light several monuments, megaliths and other structures belonging to the Sangam age. And from these archaeological sources, we come to know about the lifestyle of the Sangam kings and the condition of the people, their lives, their lifestyle, each and every part of people's activities give us vivid impression, vivid ideas about the Sangam age. Excavation in Archimedes led to the discovery. Sorry, my dear students, it makes noise due to heavy shower suddenly came. Anyway, so excavation at various places in around Tamil Nadu, Kerala, gives us detailed information about the activities of the, you know, activities of the kings, activities of the people, activities of the common men and all mass. Excavation in Archimedes led the discovery of several places of Roman pottery, glass, bowls, gems, coins, etc. These findings confirm that the commercial contact also was there between the ancient Roman Empire and the Chola Kingdom during Sangam Age. That means international trade and international trade also was there with the Roman kingdoms during Sangam Age. That means the Cholas were fond of establishing, you know, international trading relations with foreign countries. It was Rome, the most important country of, you know, Europe. There was a trading relationship between Rome and, you know, Chola Kingdom during Sangam Age. Some important sites include ancient cities near the three important rivers in the region. Some sites are Kanchipuram Palar, Pedur Kaveri, Algariri, and Urayar. These are the most important centers of trade and commerce. From there, you know, traders and businessmen, they export their qualities or they import various types of goods, purchased it, sold it, and they also stored it in their godowns and warehouses. That's why these were the important centers for trade and commerce during the, you know, Sangam Age. Now next one, megaliths. What is megaliths? The word megalith usually refers to a stone of prehistoric age of great size. Big stones, like stones of prehistoric age. The Sangam Age megaliths, some of them belonging to the Iron Age, are essentially considered to be the stones of ancient age, and these big stone slabs that were built upon the places of burial. So these big slabs made of stone were built in order to use it on the dead body during the time of burial. That's why megaliths means, you know, big stones of different size, and these were used as a part of ceremony, as a part of various procedures, various burial procedures. So it required during the time of burial customs and traditions. That's why these big stones were made stone slabs were made during Sangam Age and were utilized. Now hero stones. What is hero stones? Virakkals or hero stones are memorials. Why? Because in the form of stone monuments commemorating the honorable death of war heroes during the Sangam Age. A hero stone usually has an inscription at the bottom with a narrative of the battle and displays a variety of adornments, such as relief panels, such as statues, such as figures carved on the stone. So whenever a ruler died fighting against his enemies, just like a hero, during that time that hero stones were used while while burial customs and traditions, the hero stones or hero slabs were, you know, fixed on the dead body of the hero or dead body of the, you know, dead kings. The ritual of erecting hero stones finds a mention in ancient Sangam Age grammatical works. According to Sangam literature, hero stones were erected in honor of the person who died for the common cause of the village, the country, or the king. That's why they were treated as hero. Suppose one king went to fight against his enemies, but he died while fighting. But the body, whenever it was, you know, recovered, the body which was somehow they managed to recover the body, or they were able to take out their bodies from battlefield, that very person, that very king, was treated as a hero, and hero slabs made of stone used while moving his body, and the stone heroes, hero stones were used during the process of burial. That's why, my dear students, some customs and traditions were there which were maintained by the kings during Sangam age. It was the system of the society. It was the tradition of the Sangam age. Uses of burial stones, hero stones, uses of megaliths. These were the part and parcel of the Sangam age. Their social, customs and traditions, their religious beliefs and faiths, they all maintain it strictly and utilize it utilize it in their personal matters. That's why Sangam age means megalithic age. According to some historians, it is said that Sangam age means megalithic age. Sangam age means hero age, hero stone age. Sangam age means dramatical age, epics of different stories, based on different stories. Sangam age means poetical age, age of the poets, age of the poems, according to some historians, it is said. And why is it said? We came to know by reading the history of the Sangam age. We came to know about the dedication of the Tamil kings, dedication of the Chera kings, dedication of the Chola kings, dedication of the Pandya kings, and the role of the Pallavas. So the kings who played an important role in the history of South India, their dedication, their contributions, their bravery, their skills, and their patronization for the poets, and the contributions of the poets and their poems, the subject matters of their poems, the themes of their poems, the role of the poets, the role of Thiruvavilar, and their books. These points we came to know from the history of the Sangam age. That's why, my dear students, you have to keep some most important points in your minds. Number one, megalith period. Why was it called megalith period? Why was it called hero stone period? Why was it called, excavation period? The excavation, many sites were excavated by the archaeologists. They came to a conclusion that these were the areas the Sangam age flourished, and the kings of South India ruled for many years. They were the Cheras, they were the Cholas, they were the Pandas. There were three prominent kingdoms in the history of South India who ruled for many years. Although the Cheras were defeated by the Pandas, yet they ruled for many years, and they contributed a lot in the field of literary development, literary skills for the poets and readers. Only for that reason, there was a good understanding between the readers and the poets. The poems, whatever they produced, whatever they wrote, attracted the readers, because the subject matter, whatever they choose, it was under the direction and suggestion of Thiruvavilla. He encouraged them to do it so. So under the able guidance of Thiruvalluvar, this Thiruvalluvar was a great personality, great poet, not only, but the architect of Tamil literature, Tamil language, Tamil grammar. That's why his contribution will be written in the history of Sangam age, in the history of South India. His name will be written in golden letter, the name of Thiruvalluvar. Up to this, my dear students, next day, few remaining parts also are there. I shall have to continue it. Now, so many points are there. Okay. Gradually, we shall clarify these points. No problem. If you have any problem, you let me know. Thank you.